Morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Today we are able to gather to remember the great gift of God to Mary, who was conceived without original sin. God spared her, and she takes a place among us as really first place in our lives. Also, she is the patroness of our country, and we stand before this altar asking her to intercede to her divine Son to grant to our country peace and integrity and justice. We pray for healing for those who are dying with the virus, for the many who are working so hard that they are getting sick as well as not able to work anymore, they're so exhausted. But we depend on you. O gracious Virgin Mary, never was it known that anyone who fled to thy protection, implored your help, or sought your intercession was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, we fly unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, our Mother. Duty we come, before you we kneel, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in your mercy hear and answer them. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mindful of God's graciousness to us, we stand needy before the Lord, to present to him our faults, our failings, and even our sins, and ask the Lord to heal and forgive us. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned
in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, your Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who by the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin prepared a worthy dwelling for your Son, grant, we pray, that as you preserved her from every stain of sin by virtue of the death of your Son, which you foresaw, so through her intercession, we too may be cleansed and admitted to your presence through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. After the man, Adam, had eaten of the tree, the Lord God called to the man and asked him, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, but I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid myself." Then he asked, "Who told you that you were naked? You have eaten, then, from the tree of which I had forbidden you to eat." The man replied, "The woman whom you put here with me, she gave me the fruit from the tree, and so I ate it." The Lord God then asked the woman, "Why did you do such a thing?" The woman answered, "The serpent tricked me into it, so I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, you shall be banned from all the animals and from all the wild creatures. On your belly shall you crawl, and dirt shall you eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike at your head, while you strike at his heel." The man called his wife Eve, because she became the mother of all the living. The word of the Lord. Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavens, as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world to be holy and without blemish before him. In love, he destined us for adoption to himself through Jesus Christ, in accord with the favor of his will, for the praise of the glory of his grace that he granted us in the beloved. In him we were also chosen, destined in accord with the purpose of the one who accomplishes all things according to the intention of his will, so that we might exist for the praise of his glory, we who first hoped in Christ. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "But do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father. He will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "But how can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son at her old age, and this is the sixth month for her who is called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." And Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your will." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
I think sometimes when we read of the saints and of our Blessed Mother and even the Lord, we, for some reason, approach them very stoically. We don't give room for feelings up or down or difference. We sort of take that away as we say, "Oh, though." It's like looking at a picture of our Blessed Mother on the wall. She'll never change. And so often that's how we do in our relationship with Mary and others. Say, they never change. We don't allow them to change. But they will alive, well, and they function, and they care for us, and they reach out to us. And we deprive ourselves if we don't allow ourselves. But sometimes maybe you feel guilty. "Oh, well, that so-and-so could never do that." But anyhow, do it. Like today in the Gospel. She was greatly troubled. She was a teenager, right? We think a teenager. She had courage, right? She was greatly troubled at what was said and pondered what sort of greeting might be her. She didn't brush it off. She was wondering about it. And then the angel said, "Well, don't be afraid, Mary. You found favor with God." And after a few more words and discussion, Mary said, "Well, how can this be said? How can this be to me, since I have no relationship with man?" Her innocence came forward right off the bat. "How can this happen to me? I don't know a man. I don't have a husband." And so then the angel continues, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. And therefore the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God." When I read this account, it just gives me a chance to think of our Blessed Mother in other directions. If you read it as without any feeling, well, our Blessed Mother said, "What's this? What's that?" You know, she was really caught up in it. "How can this be? I don't know a man." Obviously, she was afraid because the angel said to her, "Don't be afraid." When she communicated with the angel when he conferred to her that the Spirit of God will be upon you and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. She settled. Her faith kicked in. And she said, well, behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word. That was her great act of faith, with all of the unknown and the coming of the angel and the questions back and forth and how is this going to be and the great thing that, that God was asking her through the message of an angel. She comes to the conclusion, I'm the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word. At that moment, she didn't have all the answers either, you know. She didn't hear about the suffering of the Christ child of seven swords in her heart until the child was old enough to be brought to the temple. And then at that time, Simeon comes out from the inner closet of the temple and says, this child's going to break your heart not once, but seven times. Seven times. And that's about all he said to her. And she carried that with her all those days until the end, really, of Jesus' life, when little by little they surfaced and she became aware of what all the implication was. I always like to think of this too. Is there any mother who doesn't carry the weight of unknown in their life? No, not a one. Carrying things like hear something, presented with something, and as she was right. You'd say the same thing. How can this be? But then you sort of work it. Blessed Mother helps you work it. And then you hold all of these things in your heart. When I read the Blessed Mother story, that's what I think about it. She was just such an extraordinary young lady who God asked her to do something, didn't have all the answers, and wouldn't have them for a while. And she said yes. Whether you're a man or a woman, when a lady talks to us, you have relations in prayer with her, sometimes we get another thing and ask the question. We don't know where it's going, but she's asking us to deal with it. I can't even imagine how difficult it was for her after the Simeon told her seven times, this child is going to break your heart. She lived with that all those years until she saw her son crucified and die. Lesson? She's there for every one of us. At the greatest or the poorest or the most difficult moment, she is there for us because she was there before us.
A prayer of the faithful. My friends, we ask Mary to join us as we pray to be open to all that God wants for our world and for us.
That the church may imitate Mary's response to God's unexpected and challenging call, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For women throughout the world who must make hard choices on behalf of others, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For women whose lives are committed to the vulnerable, for mothers and foster mothers, doctors and nurses, social workers and counselors, for all women in the helping professions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For women living in violent situations, those who are battered or abused, those subject to human trafficking, those under persecution or the siege of war, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As the holidays draw near, for all whose hearts are heavy with grief, for those who mourn the deaths of loved ones, for those who have lost marriages, for those who look for work, for the intercession of Mary, our mother, whose own heart was broken, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For comfort and healing for the sick in our community, for for strength for those who care for them, a quick end to the pandemic, and for wisdom for those making decisions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of those who have passed away due to the pandemic, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the silent intentions of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, you who chose Mary from among all women to be the mother of your Son, we gather on this day in remembrance of her. Ever grateful for her place in our story of faith, may we too pay attention to your messenger of faith. May we ponder the things we do not understand with trust, that one day all things will be revealed. Most of all, may we imitate Mary's steadfast faith in her Son. In times of joy and in times of heartache, may we remember Mary's trust and imitate her acceptance of your will, so that we too may be instruments of love and signs of faithfulness in the world. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Hail Mary,
graciously accept the saving sacrifice which we offer you, O Lord, on the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary, and grant that, as we profess her on account of your prevalent grace, to be untouched by any stain of sin, so through her intercession we may be delivered from all earthly falls through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have preserved the most blessed Virgin Mary from all stain of original sin, so that in her, endowed with the rich fullness of your grace, you might prepare a worthy mother for your Son and signify the beginning of the Church, his beautiful bride without spot or wrinkle. She, the most pure virgin, was to bring forth the Son, the innocent Lamb who would wipe away our different offenses. You placed her above all others to be for our people an advocate of grace and a model of holiness. And so, in company with all the angels and all the saints, we praise you as with joy we proclaim.
Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. Giving thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, you may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who were united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with them in heaven. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with John the 23rd, our holy patron, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. In the words that Jesus taught us, we now pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with each of you.
Lamb of God, you take away.
This is Jesus, the Lamb of God, who takes away our sins. How happy we are to be called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received, O Lord our God, heal in us the wounds of that fault from which, in a singular way, you preserved the Blessed Virgin Mary in her Immaculate Conception through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please bow your heads as we pray for God's blessing. May God, who through the childbearing of the Blessed Virgin Mary willed in his great kindness to redeem the human race, be pleased to enrich you with his blessings, so that you may know always and everywhere the protection of her, through whom you have been found worthy to receive the author of life. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
And today is the feast of our Blessed Mother, Immaculate Conception. Let us pray a little prayer for the welfare of our country and all those who are in need of our prayers.